Welcome to Antenna and Wave Propagation playlist. Here in this session, I'll be going to explain long wire antenna. So let us begin this session with long wire antenna. So basically, when we talk about long wire antenna, there are basically two types of long wire antenna. One is resonant long wire antenna. And second is non-resonant long wire antenna. So basically there are two types of long wire antenna. One is resonant long wire antenna and second is non-resonant long wire antenna. I'll explain resonant long wire antenna in this session. And in next session, I'll explain non-resonant long wire antenna. This non-resonant long wire antenna, that is even referred as traveling wave antenna. So in traveling wave antenna category, I'll explain this non-resonant long wire antenna. That is even referred as traveling wave antenna. So when I'll be explaining traveling wave antenna, at that time I'll explain what is non-resonant long wire antenna. So let us begin this session with resonant long wire antenna with the basics of long wire, resonant long wire antenna. So when we talk about long wire, resonant types of long wire antenna, so that is having a length which is integer multiple of lambda by 2. So its length is integral multiple of half of the wavelength. So basically this is very important term which is there with long wire antenna. Its length is integral multiple of half of its wavelength. In long wire antenna, we have incident signal as well as reflected signal. And because of incident as well as reflected signal which is there with that long wire antenna, it is resulting into standing wave in the wire. So when we use long wire antenna, there are two types of waves which is propagating along with long wire antenna. One is incident wave and one is reflected wave. And because of incident and reflected wave both are appearing on long wire antenna, one can observe standing wave pattern. And because of incident and reflected wave both are there in opposite direction, long wire antenna is having bidirectional radiation pattern. So I'll explain how radiation pattern that is happening on long wire antenna. So it has bidirectional radiation pattern and that is happening due to there are incident as well as reflected wave. So when you talk about long wire antenna, what is long wire antenna? Long wire antenna is having a length which is integer multiple of half of the wavelength. On the long wire antenna, there are two types of signals, incident signal and reflected signal. Because of that, there will be standing pattern that one can observe on long wire antenna. And second is, due to both of the types of waves which is there along with long wire antenna of resonant category, it has bidirectional radiation pattern. So we will discuss all those things in detail. So let us move further. So this is what structure of long wire antenna. Electrical structure is very simple. This is electrical structure and this is what physical structure that one can see over here, where this is just a support and these are insulator. So electrical circuit is that only where you will be finding this is the length of long wire antenna. And that length that has to be integer multiple of lambda by 2. So length of this long wire antenna that has to be integer multiple of lambda by 2. And from one end we provide feed with respect to ground. So here one can observe this is what feed that we are attaching to this long wire antenna from one end. And other end is long and its length is integer multiple of lambda by 2. So this kind of structure which is there with long wire antenna. Now how radiation that happens with long wire antenna? So basically it has four major lobe that one can see, and that happens because of bidirectional pattern, and that bidirectional pattern that is happening because of incident and reflected wave which is there on this long wire antenna. So when incident wave that is happening in this direction, incident wave that happens in this direction, reflected wave that happens in this direction, and due to incident and reflected wave, standing wave is getting generated on this long wire antenna. We will see how standing wave is getting generated on this long wire antenna. And because of this bidirectional waves which is appearing on this long wire antenna, its radiation pattern is bidirectional. So one can see it is over this direction as well as this direction. So that is what bidirectional radiation pattern. Now here I'll discuss one basic difference which is associated with long wire antenna. Here one can see there are four major lobes, but if length is equals to 3 lambda by 2, where n is equals to 3. So in case of length is equals to 3 lambda by 2, minor lobes that will be like this. So minor lobe will be like this. So this is what minor lobe that one can see. So there is two minor lobe in case of length is equals to 3 lambda by 2. If it is in terms of 5 lambda by 2, then even pattern will be like this only. But if length, that is n is equals to 4, means L is equals to 4 lambda by 2. So in that case, there will be more minor lobes. So now here one can see there are 4 minor lobes. So ultimately, this radiation pattern that is having 4 major beam, 4 major beam, and it has 2 or more minor lobes. It has 2 minor lobe in case of n is equals to 1, sorry, n is equals to 3, 5, 7, like this, and there could be 4 minor lobes in case of n is super multiple of 2. So if n is equals to 4, in that case there will be 4 minor lobe. If 6, in that case even there will be 4 minor lobe. So that is how radiation pattern appears. But when we talk about radiation pattern of this resonant types of long wire antenna, majorly we draw it like this. So this is how radiation pattern that we draw. But what I was explaining was little in detail, like how exactly it appears. So basically when you draw radiation pattern of long wire antenna, it appears like this. But there are some difference in that radiation pattern. Even length, as I have told, for long wire antenna it is 3 lambda by 2, n lambda by 2, and where if I say n is equals to 3, so in that case only 2 minor lobes will appear. But if n that is associated with 4, in that case there could be 4 or more minor lobes. So that is how minor lobes are appearing in the radiation pattern of long wire antenna. Now let us discuss few more things. Long wire antenna as a harmonic antenna. So what happens with long wire antenna? For example, if I say for a fundamental mode of operation where we need to consider L is equals to lambda by 2. So in case of, if we consider N is equals to lambda by 2, current distribution that will appear like this. This is current distribution. And in the same case, if we see voltage distribution, current will start from minimum to minimum. That is how it will appear. And voltage will start from maximum. And as length is lambda by 2, voltage distribution will be like this. So this will be voltage distribution for fundamental or first harmonic mode where n is equals to 1 and length is equals to lambda by 2. If length is equals to lambda, or one can say it is 2 into lambda by 2. So in that case, current distribution that will start from minimum and it will complete one wave. And voltage distribution that will start from maximum from here and it will be going to complete one wave like this. So this will be voltage distribution for second harmonic. And if I say L is equals to 3 times of lambda by 2, so in that case current distribution that will start from minimum from here and its length will be 3 lambda by 2, so it will be somewhat this. So that is how current distribution will be there. And for voltage distribution, it will start from maximum and length is 3 lambda by 2. So that is how voltage distribution that will appear. So that is how harmonics are there with this resonant long wire antenna. Now when you design long wire antenna, then we need to see these parameters, where as I have told, designing of long wire antenna is based on its length, and that is super multiple of lambda by 2. So n lambda by 2, that will be the length of long wire resonant category of antenna. And one can calculate that in terms of feet by having this formula even, where this will be 492 into n minus 0.05 divided by 2. In terms of feet, you will be calculating this. Here minus 0.05, that we are doing it because of phase velocity, that is 5% lesser than the actual velocity which we calculate about. So because of it is 5% less, n minus 0.05, that is what we are doing it in its calculation. For a calculation of electric field, it will be 60 IRMS by R into cos of n pi by 2 cos of theta divided by sine theta in case of n is odd, and in case of n is even, instead of this cos theta, there will be sine theta for a calculation of electric field. And maximum angle radiation that one can justify by cos of theta max, that is equals to n minus 1 divided by n. And radiation resistance of long wire antenna, that we can calculate by 73 plus 69 log of n. So this is what you should have as a data when you design long wire antenna. Usually when we talk about antenna examination, at that time it is very difficult to remember these formulas, but I don't think your professors will be going to ask this kind of questions where they will be asking you formulas to remember. But these are the important formulas which we should have it when we design long wire antenna. Like I have seen people are using long wire antenna in so many applications. Like for example, if you have one robot and that robot is connected with one wire, that I think you might have seen, there is a remote which is having this long of wire, this much straight long wire, which is what we are connecting. And that wire that could even, that is flexible in terms of movement, and that is having that radiation pattern as it is there with long wire antenna. So this kind of small scale applications where we can utilize this long wire antenna, and if you have understanding based on what could be the operating frequency of that long wire antenna, then you can easily design those small scale applications. So that is why I have placed this designing parameter formulas to have a calculation of all those things. Thank you so much for watching this video. In next session, I'll explain few more antennas. So stay tuned with this channel. And if you have any suggestions regarding what is that which I need to include in antenna and wave propagation playlist, then you just suggest me. if I have knowledge about your suggestions, definitely I'll place videos based on that. Again, thank you so much. And you can download all those material from my website engineeringfunda.co.in, and link of that website is attached with this description of video. So you just go through it once, you will find all those things which is required to understand antenna. Again, thank you so much for watching this video.